anti-A antibody is causing agglutination. What is the antigen present here? A. When you are adding anti-B antibodies, and if it is not forming any agglutination, no agglutination. Okay, now, so here when no agglutination is seen, only anti-A antibody serum is forming antibodies, agglutination process. So then what is the antigen present in the blood? A. When A antigen is present, what is that blood group? A blood group. Sir, simple thing in the identification of blood group. With what type of antibodies containing serum, agglutination is formed, the blood group is same. For example, when you are adding anti-A antibody serum, if agglutinates, that blood group is A. If agglutination is caused due to the anti-B antibodies containing serum, then blood group is B. If agglutination seen by the both, anti-B is causing agglutination, anti-A is causing agglutination. Agglutination is nothing but precipitation-like structure. Means anti-cells and antibodies are combined. So when with the help of both the serums, if agglutination is taking place, means that indicates presence of both the antigens. Then both the antigens are present. What is the blood group with both the antigens? AB blood group. If no agglutination with any anti-serum, no agglutination with any anti-serum means antigens are absent. Okay, now, whenever you are adding antibody, no reaction is taking place by anti-A antibody, by anti-B antibody. Okay, now, so means when the antibodies are not reacting, what is that meaning? No antigens. Antigens are absent. Antigens are absent, antibodies are present. What is the blood group without any antigens? That is O. So what is that? O. So O is the blood group without any antigens and with two antibodies. Okay, now, so this is about blood typing. So how we can identify the blood group? So blood group can be identified by the anti-serum which possess both the antibodies. For example, there are two types of serums are there. One is possessing anti-A antibodies and second one is possessing anti-B antibodies, sir. When you are adding these serums to the blood, if agglutination is taking place, for example, when you are adding anti-A antibodies containing serum, agglutination took place. So blood agglutinated. What is that indicating? When you are adding anti-A antibody, if agglutination takes place, means A antigen is present. If agglutination takes place with the B and anti-B antibodies serum, so this indicates B antigen is present. Okay, so means when B antigens are present, that blood group is B. So this is the process of identification of blood group in the individuals. Let us see importance of blood groups or blood types. Right, so here in the, if you look at the importance of the blood types, sir, here blood groups plays an important role while the transfusion. So when a person get injury, he need blood. So what type of blood group can be injected? That is very important. Okay, sir, here generally there are two important blood groups are there. One is O, second one is B. Sir, O blood group is called as universal donor. Universal donor. Sir, AB blood group is universal recipient. Universal recipient. Actually, everybody used to say O is a universal donor, but O is two types. One is O positive is there, O negative is there, sir. Based on the Rh antigen, we will discuss later. So when O negative is there, this is actual universal donor. No any antibodies are present, sir. No any antigens are present. Means A antigen is not present, B antigen is not present. So Rh antigen is also not present. So then it is said to be O negative. O negative is the actual universal donor. If you take universal recipient, AB positive, not AB negative. AB negative is not universal recipient. AB positive is the universal recipient. So AB positive accepts any other blood groups. Okay, na? Sir, here, if you consider antigens, O is the universal donor, sir. If you consider plasma, AB is the universal donor. So just remember what I am trying to say is, if you take only plasma injection, AB is the universal donor. Why? Because antibodies are absent, sir. Antibodies are absent. Antigens are not there, antibodies are not there. So then AB is considered as, and plasma, if you take, AB is the universal donor. Only you take plasma transfusion. Okay. So this is about the importance of the blood types. Okay. So this is about blood groups. How blood groups are determined. How many types of blood groups are there? What are the antigens present in the blood group? What are the antibodies present in different blood groups? What is the gene responsible for the blood groups antigens production? And here, what are the antibodies? How many types of antibodies are there? And their presence in the plasma. Sir, here if you take, how many alleles are there? 3 alleles are there. IA, IB, I0. Sir, these 3 alleles are codominant, sir. These 3 alleles are called as codominant. What is the meaning of codominance? Sir, here each and every allele expresses its character when it is present. For example, sir, when you take IA, IB, actually as per genetics, when 2 alleles are present, one of the allele is dominant and second allele is recipient, sir. Isn't it? So here, when IA, IB are present, character is expressed in the form of AB blood group, sir. Means A is expressing its character, B also expressing its character. This is called as codominance. Codominance means each allele expresses its character. No one is dominant. If IA is there, A character. IB is there, B character.